Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition. I am Amethyst Lunatari.
You point, I punch.
He punches.
Swords, not words!
I just wanna... Where's the point with the puzzle? Because I did not click on those...
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Yeah, you'd like to think so. I get to that point with the puzzle. Wait, it's over here. Duh. So yeah, we can interact with four of these things. And each wants a specific object or something? That's what the guy over here is telling us about with his pet carrion crawler. I feel like I have to sneeze, and I'm trying to not sneeze. Okay. There are words scratched into the rust on the pipe. The handwriting looks like that of a child. They wailed and sighed, then they died. From the grave, I've had my kiss. Bring me, Lao, the lover's gift. This could only have been written by a terrible poet or a madman. A terrible mad poet. Well, we have the ring, right? That's the ring we found. Did I put it away? Did I put it on? That's not that. It's the lover's ring. I mean, I have it, right? Ooh. You hear the rush of wind and your hair stands on end. It seems you've placed the items in the wrong order. Ow. Well, it sounded like that one wanted the ring. Bring me now the lover's gift. How about this one? Don't give me that. I can't get all the way in the water, can I? Vala is no more, but he has left the thing behind. Give me a hand, and I shall help you in return. You wonder why someone would write such things on pipes. Here's that hand. Where's the lover's ring? Maybe because I had it in the bag of holding. And this one we can't... Okay. No sacrifice will do, but the blood of a friend true. But guilt will leave its stain if you wish to have the blade. This verse sounds like the ravings of a madman. Okay, the blood of a friend. Guilt will leave its stain. But we're gonna feel guilty about it. And this one wants the hand, I don't know what that is. Smell of dog, skin of lizard, to find the staff, kill the wizard. This is truly a terrible verse. It must have been written by either a horrendous poet or a madman. So now a horrendous poet. Something else I have in here? A staff. Or the shaman's staff, maybe? I don't see any other kind of staff. Alright, so we got the ring. right? The hand and then the staff. But we also need blood of something. I don't get blood of anything. Now, can we just put the ring here? Because it sounds like they want the ring. Alright. So it's not only we have to
find a home here if it were properly cleansed and balanced.
So it's not only we have to find the correct items, but we have to put them in a certain order. That we don't have. As you place a desiccated hand into the pipe, the fingers curl up into a fist. I don't like that. Hand and then ring? Alright, I think it wants the blood next. Where do we get blood?
Minsk, jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle!
Can we ask this guy over here? Guess we should heal Yoshimo.
Nature's servant awaits.
Yes? That we would be doing such great things.
I don't have any moderate, just serious, critical. Medium wounds, whatever they're calling it.
Every hamster has his day.
What?
Okay. Yo, Qualo.
Fine.
Yes?
Have you found the clues, child? Or must this place remain a tomb forever? I found nothing. Where should I look? Where the topside filth drains, there are the clues. Return to me ere you follow the once path, for there is much that you must learn. Take that. Where the topside filth drains.
Armored, live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Well, I think this is where the topside filth drains. We've placed one or two items. Oh, we still have it. It wants the hand first. But this second one... Oh, come on. Hopefully, hopefully we don't have to kill one of our friends.
Who says? What? Stand back for justice!
The only other friends besides us, or companions here, is this guy's friend. Are we supposed to kill the carrion crawler?
Yes?
I found your clues. Okay, meaning the pipes. Then the one has told you that it requires four things to unlock itself. The lock is more complicated than that. The keys must be used in the correct order. Ask what you will of me about the keys, and I shall give you what answers you are worthy of. Some questions I may not answer. Alright, can you tell me about this ring? It is not first, nor does it belong in the third pipe. Okay. I guess I should be writing this down. Alright, so that the ring is in the second or fourth pipe then. Mr. Riddleman. When should I use this hand? It was Vala's hand that cast the one into the depths. His suffering is of prime importance. Right, so first. The hand is first. We found that out through trial and error and being electrocuted. The staff. What use is it to me? The staff shall seal the bargain and prove your worth. So I guess the staff is last. So I'd say fourth. So then that means the ring is actually the second pipe. And then... the ring I acquired from the skeletons, according to Qualo, belongs neither the first nor the third pipe. According to Qualo, Vala's hand represents suffering, which is of prime importance. Presumably he is referring to its order in the pipes. The staff I acquired from the kobold shaman will seal the deal, according to Qualo. Alright, I'll notice nobody's saying anything about the blood. That's just gonna show up.
You point, see, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
So. Ask about the blood again, and I'll return to him. Where is it? Oh. I keep going the wrong way. Sorry guys, just keep going further away than I have to. So the third, this is the blood then. Oh no, that wants to... oh, they put the hand in first. I thought it was referring to the order of the pipe. So wait. Okay, so the order of the...
this land is fine, but I wish I could show Boo the fields of Russia. We could run free through the snow. Though Boo would look some kind of funny in the drift, I tell you this.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so I had it wrong. So the hand goes into the third pipe.
You are from Rosamond? Such a land was the stuff of fable.
No, it is as real as Minsk, though even larger. It lies far in the direction of the sun at morning. Ah, but it has been long since I left it. Why would you ever travel so far from home? I was torn from mine and had no choice. I was on my Dajema, a journey to prove my manhood. Oh, we were a pair, me and my witch. I was to watch over Dinah here and bring her home in safety. Oh, boo, I can never return to Rashomon. I am proven unworthy. I am no man, and you are no hamster. We are lost. Oh, the sorrow. Ares says, oh, don't cry. You and Boo have fought bravely. Who could count the foes you vanquished? Dinah here would be proud of you. You have been good friends, you and Sapphire. Minsk would ask something. Will you be my witch, Airy? Boo and I are nothing without a witch. Well, we're going to continue the tradition, then. If you will be my guardian, Minsk, I shall be your witch. Your digemma has not been for nothing, and Dinah here's death shall not go unavenged. My sword, my soul, my hamster. All these things I pledge to Airy, my witch. Hear that, evil? Minsk has a new witch. Woe is you. All right. It's official. No sacrifice.
Our actions are good and will serve the greater balance.
No sacrifice will do, but the blood of a friend true. But guilt will leave its stain if you wish to have the blade.
Swords, not words! Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Yeah, I'm afraid now we're dealing with words and items. So because I don't have the blood, I can't ask him about it?
Yes?
Well, I don't want to kill one of my own friends, or my own party members, so... Sorry, Qualo? That's it. Blood of Qualo's friend. I was right. I'm glad it wasn't the other thing I was thinking of. A vial of blood collected from Qualo's pet carrion crawler. You can't help feeling guilty for having had to kill his true friend. Okay.
Yes?
Now what of this blood of a true friend that the riddle speaks of? A pained look of regret crosses over Qualo's face and he turns away.
Find a home here if it were properly cleansed and balanced.
Okay. That's it then. Now we just got to get the order right. Everyone get in here. I'm just gonna rest because we're taking tiny bits of damage and we're out of our little small healing. Another dream? Oof.
Stand.
And deliver.
You rest each night uneasy. Yes, you are weary. You struggle daily. It will not end, you know, until you acknowledge what you are.
Thank you.
You walk as a mortal, taking no advantage from your heritage, from your talents within. So many things of flesh are greater than you.
Well, he was more mysterious when his name was just Arrhenicus, not John Arrhenicus.
Walk among them, these beasts that are less than you are. See their strength, see how easily you fall to their muscle and skill.
Whatever you say. Oh, is that me also? Oh, now we got a demon. It's hopeless. Demon laughs.
Why do you stand for this? Why do you submit to the flesh when death is bred in your bones?
Not sure I understand the question.
Do you realize the power you might hold? When the world of flesh is beneath you, even creatures mysterious and magical will fall.
Oh. That's an elliptic there. Now I'm laughing. So it's a demonstration.
Follow and receive the gift you are owed by the blood in your veins. Follow, if only to protect the weak that fell because of you.
Yeah, guys, I had the craziest dream. Well, let's get back to the task at hand here. Nyag ag.
Such menial tasks.
Alright, so first we put the hand. And then the ring is second. I think that was over here. As you place the ring in the pipe, it glows briefly. Okay, so then we've got the staff. This is the blood, right? As you pour the blood of Qualo's friend, the carrion crawler, into the pipe, the water turns crimson. Doesn't look crimson. And then here.
Men of stinking evil, cover your nose pool. We will leave no crevice untouched.
Okay, guys. Now the staff. Final. The seal. The deal. As you place the staff into the pipe, the water briefly takes on a greenish glow, and a strange halo surrounds all of the pipes. From the filthy water, a sword rises to hover before you. You grasp the hilt, and a scream echoes through the sewers. And we've gotten quite a bit of experience. Is that a done quest now? Yeah. I have solved Qualo's riddle in the sewers and received a strange sword which seems to have been trapped magically here for quite some time. Oh, do I actually just have it in my inventory? Oh, I do. Two-handed sword. Who can identify this? You can. Lilarcor. Lawrence Lilarcor was well known not for being brave, but for being an idiot. As the tale goes, the boastful Lilarcor left his village at the urging of his friends so that the great hero could do battle with the devious Treant. He walked for days in the dead of winter until, feverish, he found his target and began an epic wrestling match. Unfortunately, or perhaps luckily, the Treant was nothing but a craggy, old, normal oak. His friends had been jesting, not actually expecting that Lilarcor would go fight the fictionally dangerous tree. That might have been the end of it, but Lilarcor, not really knowing what a Treant was in the first place, didn't realize the truth. He eventually uprooted the oak, and marching proudly home, he declared himself a hero. Thus was born a laughing stock of epic proportions, and over time, the name of Lilarcor has became the sacrificial fool and many tales of less than brilliance. It is not known whether this enchanted weapon is Lilarcor himself, perhaps imprisoned by an evil mage or some other odd coincidence of fate, but it certainly acts in a manner consistent with his level of competence. If it is he has never bemoaned his captivity. He might not realize or care that he is no longer a human. As a weapon, Lilarcor has its uses, but many a warrior has eventually given it away. Banter such as, "Ouch, that must have hurt," "Oh yeah, got him good," and "Beware my bite, for it might really hurt," or something, is a constant barrage on a warrior's psyche. Equipped abilities. Immunity to charm and confusion. That's good for Minsk. It's a two-handed sword, though, so not good for him there. I like him dual-wielding. Requires 14 strength. So it's a 1d10 plus 3. I mean, Thaco plus 3 is pretty good. So I'm gonna store it away for now. Until we have a tank that might, you know, better make use of it. I'm sure Minsk would be fine with it, but I like him dual wielding, like I said.
Our actions are good, and will serve the greater balance.
Oh, I'm glad you approve.
Minsk and Bull stand ready. Bat kicking for goodness!
Come on, guys. We solved the riddle. Sorry I had to kill your friend.
Yes?
Who are you? What has happened to me? Do you not know me? We have spoken before. I remember you faintly. It was not me that you spoke with. It was the thing, the person, I don't know. That which compelled me was the thing that spoke to you. Someone had dominated or charmed you? I don't think that was human. Its conscience was too foreign. I can't remember. Gods, how long have I been here? What has happened to my family? Jahira says, how sad to have been kept prisoner in such a state. And by what? The presence in the sword? Does not make sense. Eri says, at least he's free now. What a poor, poor man.
A den of stinking evil. Cover your nose, Boo. With every hamster where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Alright, well, we can leave now. This seems to go outside, or I think it says it does. I'd like to know where you're going. Come on. Vince got lost here. Well, wait. That goes to the Copper Coronet. Coronet! Sorry. And this goes... Doesn't say. Oh, this area.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Alright, so we are going
that way. Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs.
I was not planning on it.
Gather your party before venturing forth.
Have you traveled much? I have been over much of Alm and Tethier with the circus, although it was not always the most pleasant way to voyage.
None of our travels have been overly pleasant, child. If your view is that we are on some carefree outing, you are desperately in need of correction.
I never said that was what I thought. And even if I did, I don't think I would need correction from such a bitter, nagging woman as you.
Oh boy. Well, it's true, Jahira doesn't seem to like her very much. Bitter and nagging, am I? Better than a wide-eyed doe with no sense to realize the universe does not revolve around her. Experience will bring perspective, I imagine. Yes. Well, I don't need the benefit of your experience, Jahira. I was asking Sapphire about hers. I just wanted to talk about her travels, is all. I have been traveling since I left Candlekeep many, many months ago. I have not been that far north. The circus mainly made its way around Am and further south. I've been to Eshberta and Moran, among other places, but people are all the same. They gawked at me when I was caged, pointed and were cruel. Once I was out of my cage, the people were no kinder. If it were not for Quail, I could not have stood it. I think I'm glad, finally, to be traveling away from the staring and jeering crowds. I am away from prying eyes, voyaging freely, on the ground at least. And I am glad to be traveling with you, Sapphire. You have saved my life and made me feel very welcome. You can be really nasty with some of these comments. I'm glad you're here, Airy. You have proven your worth more than once. You are making me blush, Sapphire. Thank you. No problem. This tavern patron's just listening to everything.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
I don't be feeling so good. Sorry, Minsk is loud. Alright. Yeah, this place. Hopefully no one else here wants to fight us. Oh, that's the lady looking for her husband.
What? Hendak? You ignorant, barbaric slave! You're behind all of this chaos, aren't you? I'll take it out of your hide!
Enough, fiend. You no longer own me. And I'll ensure that you no longer claim ownership over any other as well. I've survived your hellish fighting pit for years. You are no match for me.
Oh, we have an enemy back here. This sounds a little like Arnold Schwarzenegger.
We shall see.
I'll test your metal with cold steel.
Is there anyone else attacking, or is just this guy? Well, I don't like Letanang. I don't know anything about Hendak. Oh, he's one of the... Right, right. I helped him. Oh, wow. A diamond, a water opal, 3 emeralds, 1287 gold. That's nice. That's definitely going to help us out. I mean, that's like we just increased here by over 1,000. A scroll of... Ooh, scroll of summon Nishru and death fog.
Yes?
I'll take those. Gladly. Now...
Armored, sharpened, and raring to go!
It's finally over, Layton. All the years of cruel and evil acts you have committed for nothing more than coins in your pocket. Burn in the abyss, fiend! I owe you my thanks once again.
As do all those who are freed, I intend to take this place as payment for my slavery to ensure it is never used as such again. Oh, he took our Beastmaster key. I did not have to ask, but there is one more task that needs doing. The slavers remain at large within Athkatla, hidden at their base here in the slums. Was that the one in the sewers underneath? I pretty much took care of him, except for this one bouncer, I guess. They have many children yet that they retain as slaves. I would ask of you to rid this city of this infestation once and for all. I've already done this. The children are free. You have completed the task, I see. I can't tell you how overjoyed I am that so many children were rescued and that nobody will face slavery here again. At least for a while. I am not naive enough to think that the slavers will not return. I shall watch for them, however, and fight them if I can. No, that's a lot of experience points. You have done more than was required of you, and for that, you have Hendek's most humble thanks. I've collected some of Letanan's more valuable items here for you. I hope this is at least some small reward for the good you have done. I have dealt a blow to the slave trade in Athkatla, freeing both Hendak and the other gladiators from their prison in the Copper Coronet, as well as the slave children in the slaver compound in the slums, no more gladiators will be purchased for the Copper Coronet now that Lieutenant is dead and Hendak is in charge. Alright, let's get rid of this guy. You're doomed. Okay, are we gonna actually hit him?
Oh, faster than Jake, take a fast pause.
I can dance on the head of a pin as well. Who says what?
This Aerie was in the way?
We do good things here. All will remember the heroes that are Minsk and Boo and you.
Right you are, Minsk. Only good things will come from the examples we set. Yes, lead evil by example, and one day we need no longer put the boots to those that stray off the path of goodness into the muck and bile of villainy and track great bloody footprints across our lily-white tiles. Boo will have clean wood shavings, you evil bastards. Okay.
You point. Stand back for justice.
Does Hendak have anything to say?
Our actions are good and will serve the greater balance.
Yeah, I knew she would approve.
I will always be grateful for your assistance.
A good day to you, Sapphire. Hendak welcomes you to his inn as the champion and hero that you are. Is there something that I may do for you? I simply wish to see what you have in stock, Hendak. It's not as much as the fiend had, but it's plenty, and it's at a significant discount for you. Just speak to Bernard. I still have him handling the store. Alright, let me look at these scrolls. I could put that in my bag of holding. Oh. No, I can't. Alright, so summon Nishru. Oh, it's a level 6 spell, wow. By casting the Summon Nishru spell, a wizard calls into existence a magical being of considerable power, the Nishru. At first glance, this appears to be some sort of mist, but upon closer examination, this boiling, churning red mass of vapors and shapes moves with a life of its own. Drawn toward magic, like a moth to the flame, the Nishru feeds on the energy surrounding and used by wizards. Luckily, there is no question as to the loyalty of the creature, and it will not attack its summoner, even though it would like nothing better. The Nishru have no physical attacks at all, although physical attacks can hurt them. Each time a Nishru touches a target wizard and wraps its tendrils around him, the wizard loses one random spell of the highest level currently memorized. The Nishru is completely immune to magic, except for death spell, and magic will actually heal it. The creature will remain under the wizard's control until slain or until the spell's duration expires. Cool. And this death fog, also level 6, lasts for a turn. Well, how long does this last? Until slain or until the duration expires, which is a round per level. So death fog, 15-foot radius. The casting of a death fog creates an area of solid fog that has the additional property of being highly acidic. All animal life not immune to acid suffers 8 points of damage for each round they are exposed to the vapors of death fog. Death fog will also instantly kill all summoned creatures regardless of their hit dice and immunities. Well, for this reason alone, that's pretty awesome. Like, oh, you've summoned creatures? Death fog. All animal life. All right, let's see if we can write this. Death fog. Summon Nishru. Good. Just making a little room here. Oh, we found this too. Does she have any device? Yeah. Condor plus one. At a first glance, this sword appears much like any other. In the presence of any shape-shifting creature, however, the blade becomes warm as its power stirs. Its namesake was the original owner of the weapon, and his tale, though mostly long forgotten, was wrought with treachery and deceit. Rumors persist that he paid a fearsome price for this blade, but with it he revealed the true identities of those that sought to betray him. Their names and crimes, however, are long since lost to history. So the Thaco is plus one or plus three versus shapeshifters. It's 2d4 plus one or plus three versus shapeshifters. It's a good thing to give Minsk if we remember. He has this special shape-shifting killer sword. Who had that? Plate mail. Alright. I'm gonna call it an episode here. I've been running for quite a while. We will talk to Bernard. And yeah, see what we can buy from him. And then we'll be continuing to explore the slums district. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.
We are all heroes. You and Boo and I. Hamsters and rangers everywhere. Rejoice!